It's difficult to catch a prey underwater. Most of aquatic animals expand their buccopharyngeal cavity and they suck up the water, and it's very efficient. But snake, they cannot do that. They use two different strategies depending on the species. The first one is a strike like that, a frontal strike. And the other one is a strike like that, lateral strike. And so you can imagine that when you're chasing a prey underwater, the physics, the aerodynamics related with the two strategies are different. We 3D printed head shape of snakes, actually, and we built a setup to measure the forces that applied on the head, depending on the shape. Some have head shape that is like triangular, very short and robust, and other ones, they have a very long and thin head. We try to have an experiment that allowed us to measure the forces of both the frontal strike and the lateral strike to see if, for example, like the big heavy shape were related with one strategy and the long and thin with another one. And it appears that snakes do whatever they want. They don't care about physics, actually.
We're really interested in how birds are able to fly so stably in crosswinds and turbulence. So what we've done is actually been learning directly from birds. We have live birds that are flying in crosswinds, and we're studying how it is that they're stabilizing themselves when they see a gust from the right and the left, or one on the right and then the left. The crosswinds were designed to be serious crosswinds, so we're talking like 3 or 4 meters a second. In the arena where we were flying the birds, that's about how fast their forward flight speed is. So this is not a minor crosswind that you could just kind of trim your tail a little bit. This is the same order of magnitude as your flight speed, so you really need to make a significant adjustment if you don't want to crash. And they never crash. Essentially what they do is use some of the same strategies that pilots use when they're coming in for a landing in crosswinds. The difference with birds is that they're able to maintain their head really stably on the goal perch. So they can keep their head pointed exactly where they want to go while turning their body into the wind to offset the gust. And they're flapping it 14 times a second while they're doing this, which is unbelievable that they're able to do this. You know, it's impressive enough that an airplane with fixed wings can do this, but that a bird can turn into a wind while flapping its wings, while keeping its head straight ahead, is pretty amazing.
We used the mathematical equation to understand the flow around the human sperm, maybe like that. And what we found was the sperm swimming has particular rhythmical beating, which is like swinging, pushing, freeing, this kind of 4-beat pattern. I really look at the sperm journey from mathematical point of view. So we look at how sperm swim, how the sperm is selected, and this physical story is what I would like to know. The important thing to understand the mechanism is that is required for infertility treatment, and also very interesting when we understand what's going on. If we understand what's happening in the female body, we may have some cues towards treatment.